$1,000 cash.
That's fresh.
Pretty sure these are edible.
Sup, and welcome back to Papa Jake's Cooking, where we review all the food around my house and give it 0 out of 5 papas. All right, so right now we got Logan's lunch. It looks like a simple wrap that came from our kitchen.
Jake, what are you doing?
I'm gonna be reviewing this wrap and seeing exactly if it's worthy of a Papa Jake 5-star. First thing off the bat, you can see that the texture of the wrap is not so great, and the interior looks like a mixture of eggs and gross cheese. Unfortunately, Logan, this is a 2 out of 5 papas.
Hey, yo, what's going on, everyone? It's Papa Jake, and we are back with Logan. What are you doing? No, Logan, we're doing a boxboard challenge on Nerf Chat. Fuck, I'm gonna attack you with this. I'm like a Jedi Knight with this tong, right? Like, we are doing another box fort, $1 versus $10,000 challenge.
You already know I'm taking Jake down with only $1.
Logan, you're not gonna be taking me down because we are doing a restaurant box fort, and I happen to be the greatest chef in the world, and I make all the bestest foods.
Guys, you saw that wrap I made. It was really good. I don't know what Jake's talking about.
It was not good, okay? I'm trying to prove to you that in order to have a proper meal, you need to spend a lot of money, all right? You need a $10,000 fancy restaurant, and without one, you might as well be eating grass. Because it don't smell appetizing at all.
All right. Well, it looks like you need to put your food where your mouth is and build your own restaurant, all right? So I say we split ways. I get a budget of $10,000 courtesy of your credit card. You get $1. And then we see, based on our very own in-house food connoisseur, who makes the best restaurant.
Okay, guys, so I came upstairs, and this is where I'm going to be building my restaurant. Now, I have no idea what Logan's going to be doing. He's probably going to be using the garbage to build his restaurant. And quite honestly, I'm a little bit scared to try his food if he's really making this a $1 box for, but for mine, we are sparing no expense. And the food that I've decided to cook is gonna be next level, all right? I've got some crazy recipes that you guys just need to stick around to see. Also, before I jump into building this, I do wanna remind you, if you are brand new to the channel, do not forget to destroy that like button as well as that subscribe button so you never miss a brand new video. But let's start building this thing.
All right, guys, if we're gonna impress this food connoisseur and beat Jake, we gotta get our cardboard and start building. You already know where we gotta go. We might have a garbage problem, but that is good for me because I have all the spare cardboard I need to build my restaurant. All right, now that we got our $1 cardboard, let's build our $1 restaurant. All right, guys, here's our box fort restaurant so far. It's looking pretty good for cardboard that I found from the garbage. There's probably no difference from this to Jake's. And wait till you guys see my food. I'm gonna get so creative. This food connoisseur isn't gonna know what hit him.
Now all we gotta do is finish up the kitchen.
Kind of ran out of cardboard to finish the exterior, but that's okay. We'll leave it as an open concept patio kind of thing.
All right, guys, so update for you. I've been working on my amazing restaurant for a little while now, and this place is looking extremely fancy. This is gonna be one of the most expensive, one of the most luxurious restaurants you have ever seen in your entire life. Okay, it doesn't look that luxurious right now, but that's because I'm still working on it, all right? So as you can see, I've got our main area here. So this is gonna be where you actually come in and sit down, where you order your food, you know, you enjoy your fine dining. I'm gonna be adding a bunch of really cool stuff in here because I wanna blow Logan's fort out of the water. Like, I don't even know what Logan's doing right now, but he's just sitting there. Like cardboard. But I want to make it known that when you come to my restaurant, it's a luxury. That's why already right off the bat, I've got a foot massager. Because you don't say luxury without foot massager. Back here, guys, I haven't actually finished it yet, but this is gonna be the kitchen. This is gonna be where I'm actually preparing all of the meals for my customers, including our taste tester, who's gonna be judging both me and Logan's restaurants, not only on the taste of the food, but also on the decor, and then giving us a rating to see who's the best. Of course, though, guys, you can always comment down below, like right now, it's like a hashtag Papa Jake's restaurant's the best, or like hashtag Papa Jake makes good food.
And with a few adjustments, we have Logan's chef.
Check this out.
Refurbished, redone
restaurant.
I'm gonna need some plates, so you know where we're going. To the garage to get our cardboard.
Right, and we'll just...
What?
Looking for the cardboard, buddy? See, I knew for your $1 challenge, you were gonna be using our garbage. Which also means it's my garbage. That's why I got all of it hauled away, so...
Jake, that was what I was using to build my restaurant!
Yeah, good luck with that. You're gonna have to find some other $1 trash.
Since Jake took all my cardboard, I'm gonna have to get even more creative with how I do my restaurant. Looks like we got some spare cardboard
and some paper towel,
and that's gonna be our plate.
And there we go, we have ourselves a beautiful
cardboard plate.
Okay guys, the time is officially now to unveil Papa Jake's luxurious $10,000 restaurant. I'm calling it Papier's because it sounds French and it's really fancy. But guys, check it out, all right? My restaurant's so fancy, in fact, that we didn't want a nice exterior, okay? We wanted it to be subtle so that you could only find it if you knew about it. All right, guys, now I'm gonna save showing off the entire restaurant until the connoisseur gets here, but what we need to do is actually cook up some food because currently we have, well, no food. And if I'm gonna be winning this challenge, not only do I have to have an amazing restaurant like this, but I've also gotta have an amazing meal. Honestly, I have no idea what Logan's cooking for a dollar because whatever Logan has for a dollar cannot be good for your tummy. We have a fully working kitchen here where I'm gonna be cooking up my very own chef about his perfect recipe. Now, because I had unlimited budget, I went to one of the fanciest restaurants known to man. It's called McDonald's. So I went ahead and gathered all the ingredients that I could find from McDonald's so I could be making my very own dinner worth $10,000. I mean, this dinner alone cost over $100. Have you ever gone to McDonald's and spent $100? Probably not, but we're about to. Because I'm gonna be using a couple different base ingredients. We've got, whoa, yummy that looks. Just a bunch of meat. We've got all of our patty buns over here, fresh, straight from the farm patty buns. You know I only get fresh from the farm patty buns. And then we're gonna have another base layer of the chicken nuggets. Now, of course, this is a fancy restaurant, so we gotta make this look nice. Which is why we're gonna start by mashing up the chicken nuggets into what I call chicken nugget de la paste.
Since we don't have any food, I'm gonna have to go to the kitchen and find whatever leftovers and spare food I can find, plate it, and make it look better than whatever Jake's making. Looks like we have some cereal, which we're gonna use for our main course. You know those really fancy restaurants where they serve you very small dishes, but they're super fancy? That's what we're going for.
Here is the base of our meal.
It's a good thing Jake's a messy eater. I'll use these crumbs as a nice little addition to our meal. And every meal needs some greens. Pretty sure these are edible.
Just take a little and we are
almost done this meal. It needs one more thing.
Looks like Jake didn't eat his whole banana.
Just a little bit of this and some salt. And it looks like we have an amazing meal. Honestly, guys, I don't know how Jake's gonna top this.
There we go, we got our compressed burger with over $50 worth of Big Macs in here. Now let's check this bad boy out. The flip, it's always good to have a nice expensive flip. Oh yeah. All right, now what Chef Papa Jake is gonna do is I'm gonna extremely delicately put a thin layer of this hamburger in between multiple buns with our chicken paste. Exquisite. All right, guys, and there we have it, the creme de la creme of burgers. Chef Papa Jake's Burger Deluxe $10,000 box for burger. This thing is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 patties stacked tall and weighs as much as a small baby. Now, to make this thing even more expensive, it's not done. We're gonna season it with the best seasoning possible. $1,000 cash.
That's fresh.
Guys, if I don't get a hashtag yum 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 in my tum tum tum, I don't know what does, because this looks like the most appetizing thing I've ever seen in my entire life. In fact, if I wasn't saving this for the food connoisseur, I'd be eating this right now.
Logan, where are you?
Where is he?
Welcome.
What the?
To my restaurant.
Logan, this isn't a restaurant.
This is the Logan's Shack.
It's the $1 restaurant.
Yeah, it's definitely a shack, I give you that.
Open concept patio, table and everything.
I mean, if this is what you think is beautiful, Logan, then that's great, but I actually made a proper restaurant, okay? You're just trying to get into this chef game to prove that you can beat me,
Jake,
but you can't.
Jake, shh. We're just gonna have to see what the connoisseur has to say about it.
Looks like he's coming right now. All right, I need to go upstairs and get my restaurant prepared.
Okay, well, Logan's Shack is ready to win this challenge. And guys, if you think I have the better restaurant, put a hashtag Logan if you guys think I win.
I would ask that all of you stop as the connoisseur has arrived. I have come straight from the chef's parlor to be testing out your food and giving you a rating. As you can see, I'm an official connoisseur, courtesy of my badge.
You don't have a badge.
He's not there today, but I can guarantee you I have a badge. Enough chit-chat. Why don't you tell me a little bit about this,
Logan's shack.
Logan's shack, yeah.
I mean, you have an outside patio, a lovely kitchen, and some of the world's finest food.
Is this a 5-star restaurant, or is it one?
It has a beautiful sign, beautiful interior.
I said it before, sir. This is a 5-star hotel.
That's the wrong answer.
I mean, restaurant.
I am the only one who can say if this is a 5-star or 1-star. But it will come down to the food. That is what I am here for.
For today's meal, we have a beautiful taco salad with banana and some fresh greens from the garden.
Artisanal meal straight from the garden. Well, I hope you don't mind that I brought my own napkin. Is there no cutlery for me?
Oh no, you eat this with your hands.
Okay. The texture is nice. You can tell this was made in a nice kitchen. It sees you have a little bit of a crumble of some sort, maybe breadcrumbs. Exquisite.
So what do you think?
Honestly, this salad is so fresh, like straight from the garden. This must have taken many years to make. Must be extremely expensive.
Thank you. Yeah, it took a lot of effort and, creativity.
This has to be one of the nicest meals I've ever had in my life. I will give you 5 out of 5 stars. Now I have to go and review your friend's restaurant. Keep up the good work, though. You are truly a chef.
Alright, guys, we're back in my restaurant. And as of right now, the connoisseur should be eating some of Logan's whatever he made.
The restaurant's in order. Drinks are in order over here. All the luxurious items are ready for him when he gets in. Dining table is set, and his beautiful $100 burger
and the $10,000 restaurant is ready. Now all you have to do is wait for the connoisseur to show up.
Ah, hello. I am a Van Sinkle Mixvatersnitz, and the nicest and most prestigious connoisseur of foods in the world.
It is an honor to have you in my restaurant. I assume you are probably starving after whatever Logan gave you. Welcome to Papa Jake's Restaurante. This place is over $10,000. And sir, before I serve you your dinner, I want you to have the full experience. The first thing you get to do in Papa Jake's Restaurante is set the mood, okay? We have custom lighting in here, so you can choose the exact lighting scheme you want.
How's about we make the lights blue for me?
Yeah, we can do blue. Changing it to blue right now.
It's just one of my favorite colors, just like my eyes.
The next thing you get to choose is what kind of smell you'd like in here. And you can choose whatever scent you want to set the mood for dining.
I would prefer the Dragonfruit if you mind putting it on for me.
Get you some nice incense in here. I think it really adds to the luxury box for it. Now, before the meal starts...
What is this scent? It's a horrible...
Okay, forget the incense. You know what? How about before we eat, you enjoy a luxurious foot massager? I have it set up for you in the corner. You can relax and enjoy the billionaire lifestyle while I prepare a nice drink for you.
Well, my feetsies do enjoy a good masseuse. Not the most nice position to be in. It's a little cramps. Monsieur! This thing is hurting my feet.
You can just turn it off with the button.
It's like squeezing the bones in my body. Stop it now.
Forget the foot massager.
It's almost ruined my appetite.
Why don't we just scrap the foot massager? It's all about the food and the drinks here. What can I get you?
Perhaps I should have some water to clear my mind of this foot massager.
I'll get you one of our specialty waters. Now the thing about our restaurant, you might not have noticed this because you just probably went to Logan's, but our water comes premium from the top of Mount Everest.
Could be something my palate might enjoy.
Now to make our drinks, we don't just give you regular water. In fact, we pour it in a water purification chamber and then freeze it to -4,000 degrees Celsius. So it's extremely cold and ready for your palate. Coldest water on the planet. Here you are.
Monsieur, this is disgusting water. Oh, this is way too cold for me.
Okay, sir, forget the water. Forget the water that's on the house.
Just show me the food, no more. You're hurting me.
I'm gonna get your meal ready, okay? You can enjoy your nice meal. I have one of my specialties, Chef Papa Jake's $100 burger. Let me grab it for you. This is honestly going horribly. I thought he would like all of this luxurious stuff, but he's hating everything. All right, my last ditch effort to beat Logan in this challenge is gonna have to be my food.
Yeah, at least that's my one strong suit. I mean, just look at this thing. Probably the yummiest thing you've ever seen, right?
All right, sir, I've got your burger ready for you. The $100 hamburger.
Wow, the texture is so nice. Seventh layers here is quite good. Structural integrity of the burger is on point. And the $100 bills is a great touch. You know I like the money. I guess it is now time for me to try the burger. A hint of chicken paste. Good touch. All right, bottoms up.
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is horrible. Horrible place. I'm better for a horrible restaurant. Not a shower, but a shower.
Paul Single Snitch, or whatever your name was, please come back.
Jake?
Hey, what's up?
Is that your food?
Yeah.
It looks really gross.
No, actually, the connoisseur was just here.
Did he like it?
Loved it. Absolutely loved it. From the moment he walked into this restaurant to the moment he ran out in a hurry, he loved every second of it. In fact, he ran out so fast, I think he might have said, Jake, you won the challenge.
Okay, well guys, you're gonna have to let us know in the comments who you think won this challenge. Was it hashtag Logan or hashtag Jake?
Oh, it's definitely me. Let us know down below, and of course, do not forget to hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos just like this on the channel. But guys, this has been Papa Jake
and Chef Logan,
and we'll see you guys next time for another awesome video.